up, you guys? It is your favorite YouTuber, OG Parley. And I'm back again with another amazing video. If it is the first time you are on my channel, welcome, welcome, and welcome. If you are a returning subscriber, a faithful member of Parley World, welcome home. Bo baby, baby, libo baby. This was a requested video. I'm gonna be doing a little chit-chat and answering a few questions which I have received, namely from my comments. So yes, so I am giving what I was asked to give. So I'm gonna be reading them. This is not a premeditated video also. It's literally me switching on the camera and answering the questions as I go. So this is as organic and as honest as possible. So, and I'm also gonna try and be concise so I don't like give a mouthful of overwhelming information or whatever, you know. So okay, I am going to insert a screenshot of the name of the person who asked me to make this video. So this was underneath a comment actually. Unatim Pila, hi, said Sis Palesa must give us tips on the schedule of hers. Also, how do you wake up so early? Crying face, Sabaweli. yeah, so then I asked, would you like a video? If yes, comment talking points you'd like me to discuss. So these are the talking points. This is in no particular order that I'm going to answer the questions. So let's just take this and go with it. If you could please share, what time do you go to bed? Okay, so when I do have school, so when I say school, I mean if I have like a test or an assignment that's due sometime in the week or whatever. And even if I don't, if I just have like classes and I obviously have work to catch up, I usually go to bed at 9:30. I try to go to bed at 9:30 at the latest, but I aim for 9:00 because I can't be unrealistic and say, I'm gonna sleep at 8:00. No, 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 no. And also I, for me, I'm only like functioning at half of my brain capacity if I sleep less than 7 hours. So for me, I have to sleep like 7 hours on the dot at least. So my time is always put to about 7 hours 15 minutes. So let me open my clock. Right, so I set the thingy for 7 hours and 15 minutes. It's very rare that I wake up at 4:00 on the dot. It'll always be like 4:15, 4:05, 4:20. It's always 4 something, but it'll be before 4:30. So that's my realistic like bedtime schedule, and that is because I do everything like pretty early during the day for me to be tired by that time. And another thing with advice with sleeping, listen to your body, because you can try and sleep at 7, but your body is not trying to sleep at 7. If you feel tired at a certain time every day, that's the time you should be sleeping. Yeah, I always get tired at like just before 10, like 9:30 to 10:00. That's when like I can feel go OG lalandota lala, you're tired, you understand? So yeah. Number 2, how do you not procrastinate when your alarm rings in the morning? I sleep with a certain mindset. It depends for me. You can try this. I believe it can work for everyone as it has worked for me. When I go to sleep, I sleep with certain thoughts and with a certain mindset, because if I don't sleep knowing what I'm doing tomorrow and how much time each thing is going to need, as well as what's motivating me to do those things, I'm probably not going to listen to that alarm and I'm going to listen to my body. Yeah, so I always sleep with a certain mindset, and if that thing rings at like 4:15, it's not about what time it is and if I feel like I didn't get enough sleep but like I'm okay. No, 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 it's about, okay, you need to get to work. That's what wakes me up, the fact that I have things to do. You understand what I'm saying? And I'm also a morning person, and I know that if I procrastinate waking up, like the chances of me getting everything on my to-do list done, 0. And up. But this is another step that you can try if you struggle with like procrastinating, like waking up on the first alarm and you always click snooze. Don't sleep next to your phone. Like if your bed is over here, put your phone over there so that when your alarm rings, you have no choice but to get out the bed. And the second you get out the bed, you'll be more alert. So the sleepiness will, you know, like increasingly like dissolve and disappear as you're getting that phone. And as you're about to sneeze it, you'll be cold, because this is the cold hours, I need to, you'll be cold. And when you're cold, you're basically awake. You might as well not snooze and you might as well make your bed. And also, if you're gonna do that method of sleeping with your phone not close to you, like on the bed or on your side, whatever thingy, keeping it that side. Always make sure that when you fetch that phone, don't snooze it. Switch off the alarm and make your bed immediately. It doesn't matter how tired you are, you need to make your bed. Like, the first thing I do before touching my phone, even, like, I usually make my bed. Because my morning routine changes a lot. Okay, not a lot, but maybe, like, I'll stick to a routine for, like, a month or something, and then, like, change something about it later on. So, yeah. How do you stay active and focused when you're tired but have to study? You need to take breaks. I know I'm very guilty of not taking breaks, but then again, people are not the same. Some people can push like 5 hours of studying without feeling fatigue and still have like you know, like brain capacity to fully function and do other tasks. Some people don't, and I know people are going to be like, no, but it's bad for your brain, da, 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 da. People are not the same. Also, some people have longer endurance than others. Yeah, I know. I have to take things that support my mind, like drink certain things, eat certain things, to, because I get distracted very, very easily. So you can imagine, like, I cannot do, you know, like studying with people, you know, like I can't do that, for example. I just can't. It doesn't work for me. I need to be alone. I need to be away from people, and things usually work for me when people are probably not active. So, which is why I am very active when people are sleeping, because those are my hours to take advantage of. Because when there's this pity pity and up and downs and noise, like, I get really distracted. Like, a small noise can distract me. So for me, it's about what I ingest, how I start my day. Like, don't not eat breakfast, and don't be crazy. When I say don't be crazy, like, if you have a deadline or you have a test or whatever, or you just need to get something done, like, please be realistic. Like, if you know you're slow, like, I acknowledge that I'm a bit slow sometimes, please do set realistic, like, dedicated times and stuff. Like, I'll never tell myself, no, I'm gonna do 3 subjects today. I'm probably gonna do 1 and do everything about it, because I'm that slow. Yeah, like, just consume the right things. I eat very healthy. That's another thing. I eat for my brain, not for what I like and for my taste buds. I only eat for my brain. That's something that's very important to me. So it's definitely about what you're eating, how many breaks you're taking, and how many times you're eating. Like, I eat maybe like 3 meals a day, and I snack in between. So yeah, and I only snack on healthy things. And if you're living in res, you definitely have self-control, because you're not at home, so you are in charge of what you buy. And if you only buy healthy things, baby, you'll only eat healthy things. Oh, and another thing, you just need to be motivated to get things done. You can't always be getting distracted. Otherwise, you know, like, you need to have motivation and discipline, you know, because if you want something, you'll definitely work for it. Besides energy drinks and coffee, do you have anything you take for energy? I take Herbalife, like, tea. It's called Herbal Beverage. I call it Herbal Bev. Banaba 012. Yeah, I take that. For me, I can evidently feel like a spike in like my energy, and it's not like an energy that goes whoo-hoo, because I used to take Bioplus. Bioplus used to work perfect for me. It never gave me the highs and the lows that it gave other people. Like, it works for you and then like you feel tired. It never did that for me. I say Herbalife, Herbal Beverage. My favorite flavor is peach and the raspberry and the original. I kind of like all three of them equally, so yeah. Yeah, and water, staying hydrated really helps to be natural about everything. How you compile your schedule, having time to do laundry and stuff. Okay, so how I compile my schedule, I always have a to-do list that I do the night before. I sometimes do a weekly to-do list. I do this on my notes, like on my phone. Like, I open the notes, I'll insert the emoji of the notes I'm talking about. If you don't want to use like notes and you want a more beautiful, aesthetically pleasing, you know, productivity information keeper thingy, you can download Notion. I also have Notion, but I don't exactly use it that much. I use it for aesthetic purposes, because I'm an aesthetic person. I need colors and pretty things to function. If it's not pretty, I won't do it. I won't touch it. I won't read it. So I need pretty things around me, period. Yeah, so that's, yeah, I always set a schedule, and it's always a time schedule. I work based on time, because there's no such thing as there isn't enough time. But trust me, there's a lot of time if you wake up at the right time. Trust me. If I know a task will take me an hour, I always put half an hour more. So, just to allow for anything. And yeah, because my laundry, where I stay, there's a laundromat where you can self-service or drop it off and get it done for, have them get it done for you. I do not do my own laundry. I'd be lying to you if I said I did. I don't. I genuinely don't have time to do my own laundry, from washing the thing to drying it and ironing. Sisi angeke, angeke. Nae, yo angeke. I'm sorry, me personally, I don't have the time for that. I do way too many things in a day to be doing that. So I just drop my laundry off as I continue with other like tasks and stuff. So, and also, it's also just about prioritizing. You need to prioritize. What keeps you motivated? I think everyone's motivation is definitely different, but for me, it is definitely okay. For one, my pride. My pride keeps me motivated. I don't like disappointing myself before other people, so and also I just have this attitude of number one, like the best, the this ist, the that ist, you understand? I don't like to settle, because as I've said in several of my videos, I am not sand, I will not settle. I shouldn't have to, and neither should you. If you want something, you're definitely able to get it. And don't now put self-doubt and, you know, like, tell yourself that you can't get it. Don't speak that stuff into you, because you'll internalize it and it'll become a reality. So you need to speak things that are extreme, you understand what I'm saying? And then you need to internalize that and start working towards that. That's the only way that you'll keep your motivation. But also, your motivation is nothing without discipline. So, you know, consistently work on it, you know? Not taking naps during the day. I don't always take naps. I take naps when I don't have enough sleep, because I don't really need naps. I get enough sleep for my functioning capacity, and I eat the right things. Another thing, I think I've mentioned this once, like, it's very important for me, if I know that I'm going to be doing a lot of things that require me upstairs to be, you know, woke and woogies, I make sure that I eat good for like the day before and the day before that, like, just clean my body out, because I cannot feed my body garbage and expect it to not give me garbage. You understand? You need to give what you want, basically. So yeah, and I think eating a lot of like fast foods and heavy things can definitely affect like how you sleep and how you wake up in the morning, like either feeling too full or too hungry, you know, because you need to make sure that you eat just enough and you don't sleep too full or too hungry, so that you don't wake up in the middle of the night and have disturbed sleep, because disturbed sleep can also disturb how you function throughout the day. But yeah, I believe that you shouldn't take a nap that's more than an hour and a half, otherwise it's not a nap. There are people that sleep for 2 hours, like did sleep with a dream and everything, like dreams actually. Do not sleep. Don't take a nap for more than an hour and a half. I highly advise a nap for an hour. And when I say an hour, like, I don't know, I feel like it takes about 15 minutes to fall asleep. So set that timer for 1 hour and 15 minutes. And when you go to sleep, practice your breathing. So breathe in, breathe out. Don't think too much or you'll wake up tired. It's something I realized, actually. How you are consistent with juggling your schoolwork and social life. My schoolwork comes before anything. It comes before my social life, definitely. And I have a very limited social life. Those that know me in person and know me personally would know this. I don't go out unless I have purpose to go out, especially with this pandemic, even better. Like, I will never ever just go out just to go out. No, I do not believe that you need to go out to enjoy yourself and to have a good time and to spend time with people. You can simply do that under a roof, you know, away from the virus, you feel me? So no, I'll never just go out just because. I usually go out because of content related reasons, or having to, yeah, it's always content related why I go out. So my social life is very much constructed by my side job as a content creator, like, is definitely, like, my social life is in there. So if there's no content, there's no social life for me, and that is because my priority is not social life, it's school, because I'm a student right now, and my mother's not paying all this expensive rent for me to, like, you know, party it away. Like, no, like, in Masbonagala, when you go back home, or when you like move out, that okay, I invested, your parents must see the investment, you understand, your person must see the investment. And I just believe, like, self like motivation and self-development. Everything for self is just so important. That's how I juggle everything. I just prioritize, and I don't allow peer pressure around me. If I feel like something is making me uncomfortable, I instantly detach or get away from it, like instantly. Don't allow anything to peer pressure you, because at the end of the day, you will get peer pressured. Your peers will be able to juggle their things and get things done. You'll be too much in the pressure that you can't get anything done, you understand? So yeah, and don't be afraid of this loner narrative. Let me tell you something about life. In life, you will always be a loner. There is no such thing, even if you have ride or dies or significant others and whatnot, you will be paying for your house, you'll be paying for your cars. It's your kids, right? You'll be paying for your kids. You will be suffering internally. You will be in, you know, like in balance. You won't be balanced, you know, you won't have peace. It's always going to be you before other people. So don't allow pressure from other people to influence you, because it will end up in tears. What types of food do you eat that help you concentrate? Oof, I like this question because I just like talking about food. So things that are always in my fridge no matter what. I always have water, I always have yogurt. I like sugary yogurt, by the way. I only eat brown bread unless I buy it outside. So if I'm buying it from the canteen upstairs, it'll be white bread. I always have grapes, I always have strawberries, I always have blueberries. It's either blueberries or strawberries. I never have them at the same time unless I'm detoxing. I always have salmon, I always have broccoli. I always have rice, I always have muesli, I always have green tea, I always have mint. Yeah, that's something that if I don't have food, oh, and jungle oats. When I don't have food, that doesn't count, because that is always there. Those are things that will always be there with me. I don't care how expensive salmon is, and salmon is quite expensive. For me, I don't really believe in vitamins and stuff. I just believe you need to get your nutrients directly from the source, not an artificial source. This is just my opinion, and it's okay for me to have this opinion. If you don't believe in it, it's okay. I just make sure that I can get omega what from an omega high food. Protein what from a protein high food, you understand? So and another thing, like what works for me, like in terms of eating, might not work for someone else, because we definitely have different, like the human anatomy is one thing, but our bodies are not the same. Like, you could be allergic to this. For example, me, I'm allergic to eggs. Eggs work for people, you know. I don't want to say waste money and go and consult a dietitian, but if you know your blood type, I'd say eat according to your blood type, and then eat brain foods. Brain foods are mainly green foods, hydrating liquids, mainly being like the likes of green tea and water and stuff. Oh, and another thing, I do not eat sweets. Like, I just don't. And when I do, it's because like my sugar is very low, and I am human, so I need to increase it somehow. And the quickest way was with like a sweet or something. But I stay very far away from sugary things. So I don't drink juice, I don't drink cold drink, I don't eat sweets, I don't eat chocolate, I don't like those things. My tongue is just not for them. I don't like them. I only drink water. And for me, I believe that's a very good thing, because the body is made of water, H2O. How long do you spend on each module? Yo, I'm not gonna lie, I do not have a specific amount of time that I spend on each module. But when it comes to something like preparing for like exams and stuff, obviously because of COVID, each module is very different to prepare for. But in a day, like, I'd probably work on school things from about 6 o'clock to about 1 o'clock, and in that amount of time I could probably do 2 subjects like thoroughly, but like not finished. It really depends, because one module could have like thousands of readings, and the readings aren't even short, thousands of lecture slides, additional materials, blah blah blah, a lot of things. So that, for example, would have to take me the whole day to do, versus a module that's very straight to the point. So I don't have any dedicated amount of time, and I just think you need to do your modules according to the advice that your lecturers and tutors can give you. Because obviously, like, they know how much time should be given. I don't know about other universities or other like departments and stuff, but I know in my department, in our tutorial guide, it even says how many hours should be spent on self-study. You could literally divide that by how many days a week you want to work on that particular subject, and then just take it from there. How long do you study for in a day? The word study is really not the same for everyone, because you could be spending 7 hours doing something, and to someone it could look like you're studying, when in fact you're really not. Because like attending a lecture, doing notes for that, and things like that, that's not studying. Studying, I believe, is testing yourself, testing the knowledge that you have grasped, internalized, whatever you want to say, and just understanding and applying. For me, that is studying, and I do not do much studying, to be very honest with you. I learn my work and understand it and apply it, and then it's less studying for me to do, because I think people take a lot of time in their study, because people think studying is reading something over and 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 over, and it is not. It is understanding what you have learned, knowing it, applying it, depending on what you study also, because things are not the same for different degrees, so. But I genuinely spend about 7 hours a day on school, and then I spend about an hour on self-development. Self-development being spending time with God, basically. I need to start going to the gym, so like my routine's gonna change once again. Darn it. Lol, so I still have to incorporate that somewhere along the line. But school's closed right now as I filmed this one. Guess it's going to the gym, sweetie. I also just want to say, like, the last thing that I want to do is sound holier than thou and like the perfect student that gets 100. You are only the perfect student if you get 100%. Sweetie, I do not get 3 numbers for average, so I'm not gonna do that. I definitely do like get tired. I definitely have burnout because I do overwork myself. I definitely do get like unmotivated sometimes, and like the spirit of laziness sometimes like tries to fight me and like take over, you understand? But like honestly, it really is up to you, like whether or not you're going to be lazy or not. It's up to you whether you're going to snooze or not, because at the end of the day, no one is holding a gun to your head and no one's going to force you to do better for yourself, because it should be something that you want. And yeah, like the best advice that I can give you, like obviously once you've gotten to this point of the video, is that you, if this is for degrees, I guess it can apply to high school if you're in high school watching this, but it's mainly for degree talk. I highly advise you familiarize yourself with the thing that you're studying, and you get advice on how to learn better, understand better, apply better, and overall achieve better in your particular module, in your particular, you know, like degree, your diploma, whatever. I highly advise getting that information from your academic advisors and your lecturers and, you know, your tutors and stuff, because it's something I can't help you with. It's nothing YouTube can help you with. You need to hear it from the horse's mouth. The person marking, yeah, you kind of want to talk to that person, because at the end of the day, they're the ones looking at your work and whatnot, and you want to hear from them, like, what's the problem with what you're doing and how you can improve. And yeah, and another thing, just work with your situation. All our situations are very, very unique academically. And academically, which is influenced by personally, I'm sure many of you guys that are watching this are with deep within squads, you know, deep within like relationships, deep within like socializing and social life and stuff, which is not wrong. I am not condemning anybody. It is not wrong at all. You just need to know when there's time for this and when there's time for that. Like when it's time for school, you need to switch that phone off. Even guys, you know, there's this thing on Amazon, eh? I think they sell it maybe at China Mall, who knows, where like it's a container that locks, basically a timed lock, where you can put your phone in there and lock it for 2 hours, and there's nothing you can do to get it out until that 2 hour thingy goes ping, you know. So you can try the Pomodoro method. The Pomodoro method, you can YouTube it, you could Google it and figure out the hours and minutes that work for you. That would basically be like studying for 20 minutes. Okay, I won't say 20 minutes. Studying for 20 minutes, for example, and taking a break for 5 minutes. Studying for 20 minutes, taking a break for 5 minutes. And doing that for duration of the studying part being about, like, let's say 2 hours or 3 hours. You would feel more refreshed, and you would have gotten, like, a lot done and stuff. So, yeah, that is the advice that I have. Best of luck with your academic journey, because mine will be coming to an end soon. But I'm definitely not going to stop here with studying and informing myself. I'm gonna go on to learn languages, because yeah, it's only up from here, because when it's up, then it's up, then it's up, then it's up. Anyway guys, thank you so much. Do comment down below if you do want a part 2, and if you do, just let me know what you'd like my talking points to be.